Allow us to present to you our production of
The Wizard of Oz.
Our story begins in
Kansas.
Kansas? Yuck.
Have you ever wanted to go far, far away? Dorothy lived in a farm in Kansas,
but she didn't have anyone to play with.
Every day Dorothy sat by herself.
Hey, don't forget me.
Sorry, every day Dorothy sat her little dog, Toto.
Toto was kind of a funny dog.
She walked on 2 feet and looked very much like a little girl.
Hey!
But Dorothy loved her all the same.
Every day Dorothy dreamed that she could go far, far away.
Oh, Toto, I wish I could go somewhere over that rainbow. I just know there's more to the world than this, and I want to see it so very badly. We're in Kansas anymore, Toto.
Hello there.
Who are you?
I'm Glinda, the Good Witch of the North.
A witch? You don't look wicked at all.
That's because I'm a good witch.
Oh, I beg your pardon, but I've never heard of a beautiful witch before.
Only bad witches are ugly. The Munchkins are happy because you have freed them from the Wicked Witch of the East.
Oh, but if you please, what are Munchkins?
The Munchkins are little people who live in this land. It's Munchkinland and you're their national hero, my dear. It's all right and you all come out of tank here. It's all right and you all come out. Come out, come out, wherever you are, as we say a lady who fell from a star. She fell from the sky, she fell very far, and Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
No miracle, what happened was just this. The wind began to switch, the house to pitch, and suddenly the hinges started to unhitch. Just then, the witch, to satisfy an itch, and flying on her broomstick, thumbing for a hitch.
And oh, what happened then was rich. The house began to pitch, the kitchen took a stitch, it landed on the wicked witch, and little Robin did. The house began to pitch, the kitchen took a stitch, it landed on the wicked witch, the middle of the day. Quick, another healthy situation for a wicked witch.
The question is,
who are you?
I'm Dorothy from Kansas.
Is Kansas a very big kingdom?
Kansas isn't a kingdom.
Do you have magic in Kansas?
No, mostly we have cornfields. Oh, I'm not a witch.
Welcome to Oz, Dorothy.
We want to welcome you to Munchkinland.
And to thank you from the bottom of our hearts.
For killing the bad witch of the east.
Oh, I haven't killed anyone.
Then how do you explain that?
Dorothy looked at where the house had fallen and saw the two red shoes were sticking out.
Oh no, she must have been beneath the house when we hit the ground.
Those are your ruby slippers.
They're awfully pretty.
Put them on. How do they make you feel?
They make me feel magical.
We thank you very sweetly
for doing it so neatly.
You killed us so completely.
That we thank you very sweetly.
Let the joy of Lewis be spread, a wicked old witch at last is dead.
Ding dong, the witch is dead, witch oh witch, the wicked witch. Ding dong, the wicked witch is dead. Wake up, you sleepy head, rub your eyes, get out of bed. Wake up, the wicked witch is dead. She's gone where the goblins go below, below, below your home. Let's open up and sing.
I'm the only one who knows how to use them. They're of no use to you. Give them back to me or I'll...
keep tight to save them. The magic must be very powerful, or she wouldn't want them so badly.
Oh, you stay out of this, Glinda, or I'll fix you as well.
Oh, rubbish, she would have power here. Be gone before somebody drops a house on you too.
Very well. I'll bide my time. But as for you, my fine lady, I can't attend you here now as I'd like. But just try to stay out of my way. Just try. I'll get you, my pretty, and your little dog, too.
You must never take them off or give them to anyone. They are very powerful shoes.
Oh, I won't. Only Auntie might not approve. No one goes around Kansas wearing ruby slippers. That reminds me. Which is the road to Kansas? My Aunt Em and Uncle Henry must be worried sick about me.
You can't get there from here.
Whatever do you mean?
There's no Kansas around here, Dorothy.
You'll have to stay with us. But I can't stay. I must see my Aunt Em right away.
The only one that can help you, Dorothy, is the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
The great.
The wise.
The wonderful.
The wonderful Wizard of Oz!
Oh, I'll go right away. Where is he?
In this Emerald City.
Oh, how did you get there?
You must follow the yellow brick.
Yellow brick.
Yellow brick.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Until we get there.
Good day, young lady.
Who said that?
Me, over here.
But you're a scarecrow. Scarecrows can't talk.
I beg your pardon. You don't know much about scarecrows, do you?
I know that they don't talk. At least none of the ones in Kansas can.
Maybe they don't have much to say. At any rate, I'd be most grateful if you could help me out here.
What should I do?
This paw stuck up my back. If you could take it away.
Certainly.
Thank you. I feel like a new man. My, it's good to be free.
Oh!
Did I scare you?
No, I just thought you hurt yourself.
But I didn't scare you?
Of course not.
I didn't think so. Boo! Scat! Boo! See? I can't even scare a crow. Who are you? And where are you going?
I'm Dorothy, and I'm on my way to the Emerald City to ask the Great Wizard of Oz to send me back to Kansas.
Who's the Wizard of Oz?
You don't know who he is?
I don't know anything at all, see? My head's all stuffed with hay. I don't have any brains. I'd unravel every riddle for any individual in trouble or in pain. And my head, I'd be scratching on my
my cats were busy hatching if I only had a brain. I'd unravel every riddle for any individual in trouble or in pain.
With the thoughts super thinking, you could be another Lincoln if you only had a brain.
Oh, I could tell you why the ocean's near the shore. I could think of things I never thought before, and then I'd sit and think some more. I would not be just a nothing. My head all full of stuff and my heart all full of pain.
Brain.
I don't see why not. You're welcome to come along with us if you like.
Stop that, Toto. That's not polite.
Don't worry, he never bites.
Oh, I'm not afraid of dogs. If they bite, I can't feel it. I'm only afraid of one thing.
What's that?
A lighted match.
Well, I don't suppose we'll run into many of those on our way. Scarecrow, are you ready?
Ready.
Toto, are you ready?
Ready.
We're off.
We're off.
We're off.
And walked until they came to a grove of trees.
I don't like this forest. It's dark and creepy. We've been walking for such a long time. I'm awfully hungry.
As a scarecrow, I never get hungry. But look! Apples! I'll get one for you, Dorothy.
Hey, you can't just put that back.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know you could talk and Dorothy was hungry and I just talked.
You told you steal our apples?
I didn't think it was stealing exactly.
That's right.
Oh. Actually, I can't think. I haven't got a brain.
You can say that again.
Hey, that's not nice. You didn't mean to do anything wrong.
Come on, beat it. Get out of here. This is our card first. Go find your own room.
Well, I'm sure we'll be happy to be out of the private.
Come on, Dorothy. Come on. Hey, look. Sounds like a moan of some kind.
Why, it's a man.
A man made of tin? Did you just grow one?
It sounds like...
Oil can.
Oil can. He wants to oil him quick.
Oh, that feels good. I've been standing here for more than a year.
Where shall we oil you?
My neck first, please. My arms... I've been holding that axe ever since I rusted. If you'll just oil my legs. How can I ever thank you? You saved my life. How did you happen to come through here?
We're on our way to the Emerald City. That's the great wizard of Oz to send me back to Kansas and to give Scarecrow here some brains.
Do you think the wizard could give me a heart?
I don't see why not.
Why? Don't you have a heart?
I did once. I was in love with a pretty munchkin girl. But then the evil Witch of the West took my heart away. And now I know that losing your heart is the worst thing that can happen to you, because it means you can never be happy again. When a man's an empty kettle, he should be on his mettle, and yet I'm torn apart. Just because I'm presuming that I could be kind of human if I only had a heart. I'd be tender, I'd be gentle, an awful sentimental regarding human earth. I'd be friends with the sparrows and the boy that shoots the arrows if I only had a heart. Picture me a balcony above a voice sings low. Oh, the heart that around me, oh, I hear a beat, how sweet.
Oh yes, and I'd be the happiest man in the world.
And so the Tin Man decided to go along with them to Oz.
Scarecrow, are you ready?
Ready.
Tin Man, are you ready?
Let me just oil my ankle. There, ready.
Toto, are you ready?
Ready.
We're off.
We're off.
We're off.
Paved with yellow brick.
But the deeper they went in the forest, the scarier it became.
Ah!
Oh my God.
I don't like this forest. It's dark and creepy.
Of course I don't know, but I think it will get darker before it gets lighter.
Do you suppose we'll meet any wild animals?
We might. Animals that eat straw? Some. But mostly lions, and tigers, and bears.
Lions?
And tigers?
And bears?
Oh my!
Lions and tigers and bears, oh my! Lions and tigers and bears, oh my! Lions and tigers and bears!
Put them up! Which one are you first? I'll fight you both if you want. Fight you one hand tied behind my back. I'll fight you standing on one foot. I'll fight you with my eyes closed. Ha! Pull an axe at me, eh? Sneaking up on me, eh? And why? You scared, huh?
Stop that! Stop that! That's not polite!
But I'm the king of the forest. I'm not supposed to be polite, am I?
It doesn't matter who you are. It's unfair to try and bite a poor little dog, go after a poor scarecrow and tin man.
But I'm a lion, see?
You're nothing but a big coward.
I know it. I've always known it. How can I help it?
There now.
I'm a big coward.
You're supposed to be king of the forest. Maybe you have a heart disease. If you have, you should be glad. I have no heart at all.
Maybe if I didn't have a heart, I wouldn't be such a coward.
Do you have any brains?
I suppose so. Never looked to see.
Sounds solid to me. We're on our way to the Wizard of Oz, and he's going to give me brains. As you can see, my head's all stuffed with hay.
Do you think the wizard could give me some courage?
Just as easy as he can give me brains.
Or give me a heart. Or send me back to Kansas.
Then I'll go with you, but only if you don't mind.
Well, that's a very polite way to put it. Of course you can come. Scarecrow, are you ready?
Ready.
Tin Man, are you ready?
Ready.
Lion, are you ready?
Ready.
Toto, are you ready?
Ready.
We're off.
We're off.
We're off.
We're off.
So they set out for Emerald City.
Soon they came upon a beautiful field of flowers.
Oh look, aren't they beautiful?
Beautiful!
But Dorothy and
window. Then if you breathe too many flowers,
they can make you sleepy.
Very, very sleepy.
What should we do?
The smell of the flowers is putting them to sleep.
Not be made of flesh and bone. The flowers didn't bother to him and are a scarecrow.
Oh, I think I'll take a little nap.
No, the lion's falling asleep. You take the lion. I'll take Dorothy the dog.
Come on, you big lug.
This way.
When they woke up, they were surprised to see that they had been sleeping in the wizard's front yard.
Tin Man Lion, wake up!
Why, it's the Emerald City! Look how fast it's in the sun!
Come on! So they ran as fast as they could, until they came to big green doors.
The doors were studded with dazzling emeralds.
Dorothy rang the bell, and the lion knocked.
Stop that!
Stop what?
Ring an infernal bell! How can you do such a thing at this hour?
Well, it's 11 o'clock in the morning.
Exactly. Go back at a decent hour.
Please, sir, we've come to see the Great Wizard of Oz.
And what makes you think he'll see you?
We've come a very long way.
Through the deep, dark forest.
Very deep. Very deep.
I don't care where you come from. Now go away.
Well, I never.
You again.
You're not being very polite, sir.
I'm the gatekeeper to Oz. I don't have to be polite.
Everyone has to be polite.
Really? I never heard that before. Are you sure?
Very sure.
Then I suppose I better let you in.
You mean you let us see the wizard?
Of course not. I'm merely being polite.
Please, sir, we must see the wizard. I have to get back to my home in Kansas.
And I need a brain.
And I need a heart.
And I need courage.
And what do you expect me to do about it?
They told us the wizard could do these things for us.
They did they? And who are they?
The Good Witch Glinda and the Munchkins.
Ick! Munchkins? I hate Munchkins.
Well, they were very nice to me.
Alright. I'll let you in. But you be polite, lady. Everyone has to be polite, you know.
Yeah.
grey chair, and above the chair
was a grey head that seemed to fill the air.
After a while, the head spoke.
I am the great, the wise, and the wonderful Wizard of Oz. How dare you disturb me from my wizardness? Who are you? Explain yourself.
I am the small and meek Dorothy. Please, your wizardship, you've come a very long way to ask your help. I have to get back to my home in Kansas.
Why should I do this for you?
Because you are strong and I am weak. Because you are a great wizard and I am only a little girl.
You have no right to ask me to do anything for you. Unless you do something for me.
What should I do?
Kill the Wicked Witch of the West.
I can't do that. If you're so great and wonderful, why can't you do it yourself?
Because I do not know. Now go away and do not disturb me until you have done what I ask.
But what about the rest of us? I need a brain.
And I need a heart.
And I need courage.
You must help Dorothy kill the Wicked Witch of the West. Don't come back until you do. I have spoken.
I'll never get back to Kansas. I guess I'll never see my Aunt Em again.
Don't cry, Dorothy.
Oh, you're making me cry.
You can do it, Dorothy.
We'll help. I'll scare like I've scared the crows. And I'll bopper up my trusty axe.
And I'll roar so ferocious. You think I had courage?
Follow me. I'll show you where to go.
And so the gatekeeper pointed them in the right direction, towards the castle of the Wicked Witch of the West.
Now the Wicked Witch of the West only had one eye, but she had a powerful telescope and she could see everywhere.
Well, isn't that sweet? What's the little girl's name again?
Dorothy, if you please, oh Great Evil Witch of the West.
Well, I don't please. They're trespassing in my territory. Where do they come from?
They were sent here by the Wizard of Oz.
Oz, is it? That weak little wizard is at it again, is he?
They come to kill you, Great Evil One.
Never, I tell you, never. I've got a great surprise for that silly little Wizard of Oz. Get them, my pretty. Bring them to me.
Run!
So, you thought you could kill me, you silly little girl. Didn't take long before I'd capture you. I know what you're up to. The wizard sent you to kill me. Isn't that amusing? Hey, Scarecrow.
Catch! You burning torch at him.
How could you? You might have killed him. They don't call me wicked for nothing. Just fighting a little fire with fire. See them! Take a scarecrow to the barn and scatter him around the hay. Take a tin man to the waterfall. That'll dress him up nicely. And this great lion. Harness him like a horse and put him to work.
You wicked thing.
Sweet little Dorothy. Here's my broomstick. Get to work. Yes. Well, don't you stand there.
Yes, your wickedness.
Fight the way, your evil chick.
Your wish that command.
Get to it. And when you're finished, you can mop the floor. Be quick about it. The shoes. Those shoes.
Glinda told me never to take them off.
Glinda, I'll get that scooters back. Give me those shoes.
No.
Monkey, come to me, my pretty.
No, get away. I'll never drop the ruby slippers, never.
Dorothy grew so angry that she picked up the bucket and threw it on the Wicked Witch.
Ah! What have you done? A melting, save me.
You
You've killed her.
You've killed our witch.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't know water could make her melt.
Hip hip hooray!
Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray!
Jump on, Greg.
She is a very evil witch. You have saved us from her. From now on, we pledge ourselves to you, Dorothy.
All hail Dorothy. All hail Dorothy.
Nice monkeys.
Ring the bell, Dorothy.
Dorothy, back again already? Didn't the wicked witch capture you?
Yes, for a while she did.
And she let you get away?
She couldn't stop us. She melted, see? We brought a broom to prove it.
Goodness gracious. Wait until the wizard hears about this.
So the gatekeeper led him into his throne room.
I am the great, the wise, and the wonderful Wizard of Oz!
Please, sir, we already know who you are. Don't you remember us?
I remember everything, because I am so great and wise.
You already told us that. It's not polite to repeat yourself.
Be surprised, Wizard. No one had ever spoken to him like that before.
But, I'm the Wizard, the wonderful Wizard.
Yes, yes, we've come to claim our promise.
Promise? What promise? I don't remember any promise.
You said if we kill the Wicked Witch of the West, you'd send me back to Kansas.
You promised to give me a brain. You promised to give me a heart.
And you promised to give me courage.
You promised.
Yes, well, come back tomorrow.
We can't wait till tomorrow. We want to go to Kansas today.
You have to keep your promise to us.
Let's see if this works.
Hurrah!
Toto, stop! Who are you?
I am Oz, the great, the wise.
You're not a wizard at all. You've been lying to us.
I'm afraid so. I am what you see here, an ordinary man. I was riding in a hot air balloon one day, and the wind carried me to Oz.
This is terrible. How will I ever get my brain?
I think you're a very bad man.
No, my dear. I am a good man, but I am a very bad wizard.
How will I ever get my courage now?
Well, it's true that I can't work magic. I'm from Omaha, and there's really no magic there. But I do think I can help.
You can give me brains?
You really don't need them, you know. You learn something new every day, and that is how one gets smart. But I do think I have some fresh hay around here. Here it is. Let's stuff some in there. And then, of course, I can give you my diploma.
Diploma?
From the University of Omaha. Here you go. How do you feel?
I before E, except after C.
Hey! Spell Mississippi.
M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I.
It works! And as for your heart, I've been saving this from a Valentine's Day. Long ago, a pretty little girl gave it to me. If there's any love left in it, it should do the trick.
Is it a kind heart?
Yes, very.
Then it's perfect. What about my courage?
Very well, I'll get it for you.
What is it?
Well, if it were inside you, it would be courage. Courage is always inside yourself. If you are brave enough to drink what is in the bottle, then you will have courage.
I'll do it.
How do you feel?
Full of courage, like the king of the forest. Ah!
But what about Dorothy? How will she get back to Kansas?
That's a tricky one. But I do think I have a solution.
You do?
I came here in a hot air balloon, but of course it was destroyed in the landing. But I've been making a new one out of hot air and silk.
The water has failed to bloom.
I'm not sure which direction Kansas is in, but I do believe this will get us further than we are at the moment.
Oh, it's wonderful. Can we go now?
Climb aboard.
Let's go, Toto.
Toto?
But at that very moment, someone in the crowd is eating their lunch, and Toto is very hungry.
Toto, come back.
Hurry, Dorothy. Can't you see the ropes are snapping? Climb on.
Come back. I want to go with you.
I can't come back, my dear. So sorry. Goodbye.
Dorothy watched as the wizard drifted away in the sky.
But while everyone was watching the wizard drift away, another figure appeared in the clouds.
Look, it's Glinda, the Good Witch of the North.
I've heard of your travels, sir. Do you want to go home to Kansas very badly?
Oh, I do so. Can you tell me how?
You have magic. You have always had it with you.
I have?
It's in the ruby slippers. All you have to do is click your two heels together three times and say there's no place like home. And in the blink of an eye, you'll be home.
Oh, good witch, I can't thank you enough. I guess this really is goodbye this time.
Go on, Dorothy. Be strong. Go home to the ones you love.
Here goes. There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
Dorothy!
Oh, my darling child.
Aunt Em, Uncle Henry, there's no place like home.
All hail Dorothy. All hail Dorothy. All hail Dorothy.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, thank you very, very much for being such a wonderful audience. This is our, as I said earlier on, our third performance. Sorry, not ours, that's the children's third performance. And each time they've absolutely surpassed themselves. The amount of work that's been put into it, particularly by the children over the last couple of months and particularly over the last couple of weeks, had to be seen to be believed. They're a credit to yourselves. I'm sure you're very proud of them. We in Scoil Mhuire are very proud of them. I know you're very proud of them, and they should be very, very proud of themselves. Give them a big, big round of applause. As I said to the people who were here last night, the last couple of weeks have been, they've been very different sort of times in Scoil Mhuire, and the normal routine has been disturbed, but I hope you'll agree that it has been very much worth it. We try as far as possible to expose the children to as many different learning experiences as possible. I'm not going to list the learning experiences that the children have got from taking part in The Wizard of Oz, but all I'd like to say is that they're lifelong. I'm sure in 20 or 30 or 40 years' time, their tables and their spellings and their grammar will be, well, hopefully not long lost. But I think the likes of tonight and the memories of preparing for it, and particularly the memories of taking part in such a fantastic performance, will live long in their memories and in your memories. Like I said last night also, I'm not going to list out individual people in general. There's so many people who have put such an amount of work into it, as you can see from the colour, the costumes, the makeup, the stage, the lighting, the sound, our musicians, all the teachers, all the pupils, and also yourselves, the parents. You've been very patient. We've asked you for numerous things on numerous occasions. You always come up with the goods. It never ceases to amaze us. Thank you very much for that. As I said, I'm not going to single out, or I wasn't going to single out any one person in particular, apart from the person who directed the whole operation, Miss Brona Halpenny.